Welcome back to the Anker SOLIX channel. In today's video, we will be walking you through the installation of the Anker SOLIX F3000 along with the smart meter and bi-directional inlet box. This will allow you to optimize your home's energy use and enable smart grid interaction and self-consumption modes. Once our installation is complete, it will give you the ability to connect solar panels to the F3000 and store generated power and power from the grid when prices are low during the day, for release later on when prices are high or through the night. But before we begin, there are a couple of important pointers to remember. You'll want to choose an install location that has a strong Wi-Fi signal. You'll also want to make sure that you turn off your home's main breaker, as well as any solar breakers you may have for grid-tied solar panels. Additionally, if you feel uncomfortable by any part of this process, make sure you consult with or hire a professional electrician to help you with the job. You'll also want to make sure that you downloaded and installed the Anker app on your smartphone. Now, before we get started, let's take a look at what's included in the box with the smart meter and the bi-directional inlet box. The smart meter itself is this device right here, and it will live inside of our main breaker panel. It will connect to the antenna for communicating with Wi-Fi, and it will use these current sensors here that will be clipping onto different wires inside the box to monitor the current into and out of the panel so you can have an idea of where your energy is going. Next, we have the bi-directional inlet box. This is what we'll be installing for connecting to the F3000. You can either do that by installing a new circuit just for that or installing it in place of an existing outlet. If you're going to be installing it where there's an existing outlet, Anker includes this tool here for locating the circuit breaker associated with that outlet to take the guesswork out of finding that in your main panel. Along with it, you'll get this included RS-485 cable for communicating between the smart meter and the bidirectional inlet box, along with some mounting screws for installing it to the wall. Now, there are some other things that are not included that you'll also need, and your installation may vary, but let's take a look at some of those now. For installing this in a new circuit, you will of course need a circuit breaker for that location, and the minimum ampacity we recommend for that is 20 amps. This is a 20 amp circuit breaker that's compatible with my home's breaker panel. You'll also want to pick up some watertight conduit, which we recommend for this install for installing that new circuit, along with the appropriately sized conductors for taking power to and from that circuit. In our case, we want a 20 amp circuit, which means we're gonna be using some 12 gauge wire for that. And you'll also need a box that we will bring the power to and mount the bi-directional inlet box on. Now that we have everything we need to begin our installation, let's start by turning off our home's main breaker panel, as well as any PV input breakers, so that we can make sure our panel is de-energized before we begin our install. Now that our breaker's off, we can go ahead and remove the panel's cover plate and begin with the first step of this install, which is installing our smart meter. We'll want to choose a location inside our panel to install the smart meter, and for me, I'm just going to let it live right here in the bottom of the panel. Now, the meter itself requires power from both the L1 and the L2 supply lines, and we'll do that by splicing in off of a 15 amp breaker that are next to each other, one from this side, which will be L1, and one from this side, which will be L2. Then we'll go ahead and mount our antenna on top of the box, making a knockout for the wire to run, and connect it to this port right here. When you're selecting the breakers that you want to use, we'll be using 15 amp breakers, and by choosing ones that are next to each other, we'll be making sure that we connect to both the L1 and the L2, because in a typical breaker box, the breakers alternate L1 and L2 being their supply as you move down. So by choosing this breaker, that will give us our L1, and this will give us our L2 power supply. Some circuit breakers have the ability to connect two conductors into them, which is great for our purposes, but if we look at this breaker here, it already has two wires connected to it. So what we will do is we will pull one of them out and we will make what's called a pigtail and create an NEC approved splice that allows us to tap into this breaker to feed our smart home meter. Now we've combined the two wires that originally went into that circuit breaker into one, and that's going to free up a spot on the circuit breaker for us to connect the wire that's going to feed smart meter. All right, now that we have our neutral L1 and L2 wires installed, and make sure that they are 14 gauge because that is all that will fit in the ports of the smart meter, we can go ahead and install those and get them clamped down. Now that we've made those connections, let's go ahead and install the antenna and the current transformers. Now, when you're installing the current transformers, it's important to make sure that you install the CTL1 to correspond to the L1 power that you have going into the smart meter, and the L2 to go into the L2 line that corresponds to the L2 power going into the smart meter. And you also want to make sure that this little P1 on it is facing the direction of your power source, which in our case is the grid. So I'll do that facing away from the array of breakers in the box there. And we'll do the same for the other side. Now that we have all these connections complete, we're gonna go ahead and power everything back on with the main breaker and the two branch circuit breakers that supply power to the smart meter. We'll connect it to the app and verify that everything's working before powering everything off and proceeding to the next step, which is installing the bi-directional inlet box. Now that everything's powered back on and we have the power light indicating that it's powered up, we can go ahead and open the Anker app and connect to it and pair it to our smartphone. So we'll go here, click add device, smart meter. Now we'll go ahead and select the Wi-Fi network that we want this to connect to. And this is when it's important to make sure that you have a strong Wi-Fi signal, which we already did. All right, and now we're connected. The lights have gone solid. Now that we've connected and paired the device, updated the firmware, we can see on our app exactly how much power my home is using on both L1 and L2. It's all visible right here. Now with the smart meter successfully installed, we can proceed with installing the bi-directional inlet box. Now, whether you're adding the bi-directional inlet box to an existing circuit and replacing an outlet, or installing it on a new dedicated circuit, installing this, the smart meter, is the same. Now, let's go ahead and kill power to the house and begin our installation of the bi-directional inlet box on its own dedicated circuit. The first step in installing the bi-directional inlet box when you're doing it on a dedicated new branch circuit is selecting the install location. And just like before, we want to make sure that it's a location that has strong Wi-Fi signal. And for us, we want to make sure that it's also within reach of the RS-45 cable. And so for me, it's going to work out great if you just go ahead and install that right here. That'll be nice and low so that I can plug in the F3000, and it's still within easy reach for this cable, and it has great Wi-Fi signal. The next step we're going to do is go ahead and knock out one of the knockouts in our main panel, and we will install our waterproof conduit from there down to where we mount the bidirectional inlet box. The first step in mounting the bidirectional inlet box to the wall is to go ahead, open this up, and we will disconnect the bidirectional inlet from the breaker here, and we'll unscrew these two screws here, and that will allow us to pull this whole top assembly off, just like that. Now we will remove the two screws that hold the faceplate on our box and the two screws at the bottom. Now before we mount it to the wall, it's a good time to go ahead and clear your knockouts so that we can attach our conduit to it. Now with that removed, we can go ahead and mount this to our wall. We'll want to make sure it's nice and plumb and right where we want it. Now I'm going to go ahead and throw some clamps up just to secure this to the wall. Now with our conduit ran, we can go ahead and run our power supply from our circuit breaker in the main breaker box, including our RS-45 communication panel to the bidirectional inlet box. And sometimes it's easiest to go ahead and disconnect the conduit from the fitting to get it started. Now that we've got all of our wires ran, we're gonna go ahead and finalize the connections into the back of our bidirectional inlet box, including our RS-45 cables. And then we'll finish up on the other end, terminating those into the circuit breaker and the smart home meter. Once that's done, we'll be able to connect our F3000 to the bidirectional inlet box, configure everything within the app. The connections on the back of the bidirectional inlet box are pretty straightforward and they're labeled. We'll connect our white or neutral wire here. Our ground goes to the green screw, and then our line connection goes to the gold screw. And then our RS-45 cables are labeled here. We have A on the right and we've got B on the left, and we'll want to make sure that those match up with what's labeled on the wires. Now we'll go ahead and connect this back like it was. So now we're back at the main breaker panel, and these are the wires coming in from our bidirectional inlet box along with the RS-45 cables. These are going to connect into our smart meter right here, and then we'll take this, connect the ground to our ground bar, we'll connect the neutral to our neutral bar, and then we'll connect our line to our new 20 amp breaker. Now we're ready to make the last two connections into the smart home meter using the RS-45 cables in the A and B slots. Now we'll go ahead and connect the final current transformer around a loop of wire that I left when I connected our branch circuit for the bidirectional inlet box to the breaker here. And since this is on our L1, I'm gonna go ahead and connect it to the B1 current transformer. Again, you want to make sure you get the orientation of this correct. With all these connections complete, we're ready to go ahead and button everything back up here. And it's a good time to go ahead and just double check that you've got this antenna connection nice and secure there, that these connections are secure, and the other connections going into the smart meter are all good. Now everything's back together, we can go ahead and turn on our main power and flip on the breaker that supplies power to our bi-directional inlet box. Now we can go ahead and connect our F3000 and use the Anker SOLIX app to finish setting up our network. Now that everything's plugged in and connected, we'll go ahead and open the Anker app and finish our setup there. We'll want to make sure that our F3000 is connected to the same Wi-Fi network as our smart home meter. Let's go ahead and do that now. With everything connected to the same Wi-Fi network and the firmware updated, we'll go ahead and open up the Anker app and click on the home button. And from there, we'll hit the plus icon. And we'll use that to manually select the F3000 and the smart home meter and add that to our home system. And then we'll go through a system test here. Now we'll go ahead and go outside and turn back on our solar photovoltaic circuit breaker. Now the final steps are configuring the charging settings, and that's based on the circuit that we connected it to. Since we have this plugged into a 20 amp circuit, we can go ahead and max that out at 1800 watts. And we'll go ahead and fill out the last of this. It'll start the electricity scene. We can set our battery reserve, and we can select if we want to do self-consumption or time of use. And again, that'll be based on whether or not your utility uses time of use metering and how you want to optimize your own energy needs, which is one of the great advantages of this type of system. And just like that, we can look at this and see that we have our whole setup configured. Now, one of the biggest advantages of the bi-directional inlet box and its installation is that it's compatible with an install method that replaces an existing outlet box. So instead of adding a dedicated circuit like we just did, you can simply replace a standard household outlet with the inlet box and get all of the same advantages as before. Now, regardless of whatever installation method you choose, the install of the smart meter is the same. So with that completed, let's now take a look at how to install the bidirectional inlet box in place of a conventional wall outlet, beginning with locating where that wall outlet circuit enters the main panel so that we can safely cut power and proceed with work from there. The first step in replacing a conventional outlet of the bidirectional inlet box is locating what breaker controls power to that outlet, and we'll do that using the included circuit breaker locator. We'll start by plugging the transmitter into the outlet that we want to replace. Now, to find that circuit breaker, we'll head over to our main panel. We'll turn this on, and we're going to slide it along the row of breakers, and we'll hear the beeping increase, and when it locates the breaker we're looking for, the light will turn green. And so there we have it. That is the breaker we want. And so I'm going to go ahead and flip this breaker off, and we should see the light on the transmitter also turn off, indicating that we've lost power to that circuit. With that outlet removed, we can go ahead and break our inlet box apart into four different pieces, like so. Open this cover up. We'll go ahead and remove these two side screws here. Remove this assembly from it. And then we'll remove the two screws up here and the two screws at the bottom to take the top cover off. Go ahead and separate that, and we can go ahead and eliminate this as we won't be needing it for the rest of the install. Next, we'll take this guy and we will wire it to our neutral, hot, and ground wires. And we're also gonna go ahead and connect our RS-45 cables that we already ran. We'll tuck those into the junction box, and we will position this outlet back in place just as if it were a regular outlet. And then once we have that where we like it, we'll reinstall this cover and screw it down. With that wired up and reinstalled, we can go ahead and replace this part of the inlet box. And now we'll just go ahead and secure the screws on either side. And with that complete, we're ready to go ahead and connect our F3000 and program it just like we did before, setting it up for our own individual use case so that we can optimize our home's energy usage. Now, it's worth pointing out in my particular installation, because I have a surface mount junction box that my outlet was in, it's off of the wall. If this was in a conventional outlet that you would have in a normal home that's recessed in the wall, it wouldn't protrude out nearly as far, and you'd get a much better looking result. But alas, here we are in the basement working with concrete walls. Once our work on that circuit is complete and we have it put back together, before we connect our F3000, we can go ahead and turn power back on. Well, I hope this video was helpful in walking you through the installation process for combining your F3000 with the bidirectional inlet box and smart meter to give you intelligent energy control over your home, helping you maximize your savings and optimize your energy independence. We highly encourage you to hire a licensed electrician for this install. and use this video only as a guide to help you understand how you can do it. Well, I hope you found this installation walkthrough helpful in showing you how to install your F3000 bidirectional inlet box and smart home meter so that you can manage your home's energy use more efficiently. As always, if you have any comments, make sure you leave them below and let us know what you think of this new product offering from Anker SOLIX. And if you like this kind of information and want to stay up to date with the latest tech tips, setup guides, or product announcements, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, Anker SOLIX, the only backup power you need.